adds numbers, right? Everybody adds numbers. So let me give you an addition. Calculator use मत करना. मुझे पता नहीं तुम लोग use कर रहे हो कि नहीं, but I'm hoping that you are not. ये add करके बताओ तो कितना है? एक, दो, तीन, चार, पांच, छः, सात. Shanton gave an incorrect answer. सात सेकेंड लिया और आंसर गलत दिया. That is again incorrect. Yeah, that is correct. Rohan is correct. अच्छा रोहन ऐड कैसे किया था? So you took about 15-20 seconds to add this, right? अच्छा now I'm going to ask some silly questions, okay? Just bear with me. What is 10 plus 7? Right. What is 11 plus 6? Again, 12 plus 5. So it remains constant, right? I hope I'm relaying my idea here. So 10 plus 7, 11 plus 6, 12 plus 5, these are all same things, right? Why is it remaining same? Because I'm increasing one number and decreasing the other number by the same quantity, isn't it? So 10 plus 7, say 11 plus 6, I increased by 1 and decreased by 1. 12 plus 5 from the initial value, I've increased by 2 and decreased by 2. So hence the sum is remaining constant, isn't it? Dekho, what you need to do is divide it into two parts. So you have like 67 and 88. Now many books would actually recommend you to do something like this. This is also not helping you because you're not doing it in one step. You're not actually doing it fast. You're basically adding single digits only. You're not adding pairs of digits out here. So in order to add pair of digits, this will come with a little bit of practice. Dekho, what you do is koi bhi ek number ko last digit zero bana do. So suppose maine decide kiya ki 88 ko main last digit zero banaunga. So I can increase it by 2. In order to keep the sum constant, I should decrease the other number by 2. So mentally mujhe pata hai ki this is same as 65 plus 90. Now 65 plus 90 is pretty easy to add, right? It is 155 because all I need to do is add that 6 and 9. Isn't it? Ab dekho wo one carry ko upar mein likhne ka zarurat nahi hai. When you're calculating mentally, you don't need to write that one carry. What you do is you add that one to any one of these numbers. So jo 35, 88 hai, usme se let's say I add it to 88. So one agar add kar diya pehle hi to 89 ho gaya. Then what I have is 35 and 89 to be added. So I need to add basically 34 and 90. So what is 34 and 90 added? 124. So isn't this simpler to add? Did everybody get this or should I repeat it? Okay, so just repeating this. So you have, what I'm doing is I'm trying to add pairs of digits together. Instead of single digits, I'm trying to add pairs of digits together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the 67 and 88 together first. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to transform this to an addition like 65 and 90. This is easy to add, isn't it, Rohan? What is 65 plus 90? You don't have to worry about the last digit anymore, right? That is the trick. So 65 plus 90 is 155. You have that one carry. Now what I'm saying is instead of adding that one separately over, jaise matlab bachpan mein kiya karte the as remove se, so what you do is you add that one to any one of these numbers. So let's say 88 pe add kar diya, to 89 ho gaya. So what you have is 35 and 89 to be added now, and that is again similar to 34 and 90 added. 34 and 90 kya hai? 124. So that's how you get the result. Now challenge yourself a little bit on this. This thing can be actually done mentally. Just try it out once. Everybody got this? I'm asking you one last time. I can repeat it again, no problem. But same thing can be applied in subtractions as well. One small exception. Again, back to my silly questions. What is 10 minus 7? Eleven minus eight. Twelve minus nine. ये सारे same हो रहे हैं ना? तो देखो, यहाँ पे difference क्या हुआ? Ten minus seven, 11 minus eight, 12 minus nine. In this case, what we are doing is we are increasing both the sides, right? Addition में क्या हो रहा था? We had to increase one value and decrease the other value by equal quantity to keep the sum constant. In case of difference, put it in this way. जब तुम पैदा हुए थे, तुम्हारे पापा तुमसे जितने साल बड़े थे, अभी भी तुम्हारे पापा तुमसे उतने ही साल बड़े हैं ना? Because whatever your age increased by, your dad's age also increased by the same quantity in these many years. So the difference of the age should remain constant, right? So what you have is 10 minus 7, 11 minus 8, 12 minus 9, all should actually give you the same quantity. Now using this, let us try one simple addition, subtraction that is. Let's say, sorry, one second. Let me do this one. Let's try this out. Devo, if you want to do it fast as well as not make a mistake in carry, just listen to this once. That is correct, but approach Shantan. That is correct, Shantan. Very good. Approach, by the way. नॉर्मल अच्छा इसमें भी कुछ अब नॉर्मल नहीं है बट एनीहाउ देखो एक चीज सुनो व्हेन वी वर एडिंग द टू नंबर्स व्हाट डिड आई से मेक एनी वन ऑफ द नंबर्स लास्ट डिजिट जीरो राइट द डिफरेंस हियर इज व्हेन यू आर सब्ट्रैक्टिंग टू क्वांटिटीज यू शुड टारगेट टू मेक द सब्ट्रैक्टेड क्वांटिटीज लास्ट डिजिट जीरो सो इन दिस केस जैसे अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू डू इन पेयर्स तो 72 माइनस 28 जब करोगे व्हाट यू डू इज 28 के लास्ट डिजिट को जीरो बनाओ एंड व्हिचएवर इज इजियर टू डू आई मीन ऐड करने से सबट्रैक्ट करके डजंट मैटर तो इन दिस केस 30 बनाना इजी है सो 72 माइनस 28 शुड बी एज गुड एज 74 माइनस 30 राइट सो दैट इज 44 And 81 minus 35 should be as good as 86 minus 40. 86 minus 40 should be 46. So this would be faster to do as well as you would never make a mistake. Because 72 minus 28, agar matlab wo digit wala thoda sa idea hai, if you try to do it, 44 aa jayega, kabhi kabhi galti se 54 kar doge, kabhi kabhi 34 bhi kar doge. So if you try to do it straight away, there is a chance that you will make a silly mistake. इसी को silly mistake बोलते हैं. तो you make a silly mistake in order to try and do it fast. So what you do is just make the subtracted quantities last digit zero. ठीक है, clear है this one everyone? Okay. Oh okay. ठीक है रिपीट कर दे रहा हूं सो व्हाट यू डू इज रेमो यू मेक द सब्ट्रैक्टेड क्वांटिटीज लास्ट डिजिट जीरो ठीक है ऊपर वाले को करने की जरूरत देखो बेसिकली व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज अगर इसमें 70 माइनस 26 किया ना स्टिल यू माइट हैव अ प्रॉब्लम विद द कैरी थिंग मतलब दो दो घटा दिया ऊपर नीचे तो 70 माइनस 26 स्टिल यू माइट मेक अ मिस्टेक इन कैरी बट इफ यू make the subtracted quantities last digit zero, if you convert it to 74 minus 30, now there is no chance of making a mistake. 7 minus 3, agar mistake kar diya, fir main kuch nahi kar sakta. But otherwise, you should never make a mistake in this part. Theek hai? So that is what I'm doing in both the sides. So 72 minus 28, I'm translating it to 74 minus 30. Haan, dono badana hai ya dono ghatana hai? Either way it works. Theek hai? So So 72 minus 28 is as good as 74 minus 30, which is 44. And 81 minus 35 should be as good as 86 minus 40. Adding 5 to upar niche. 85 minus 86 minus 40 is 46. ठीक है. अच्छा बाकी सब्ट्रैक्शन में जो कैरी ओवर वाला फंडा है वो तो वो तो बस मतलब सिमिलर है. तो बेसिकली इफ यू हैव समथिंग लाइक 8122 minus 3578 व्हेन यू आर एडिंग इन सब्ट्रैक्टिंग इन पेयर्स तब जो वो नॉर्मली जैसे करते हो यू पुल वन हियर सो यू डू द सेम थिंग हियर उसमें कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है. सो हियर व्हाट यू डू एक्चुअली 122 माइनस 78 राइट. Then the rest of the part is same. So what you do is 124 minus 80, which is 44. And in this case, as you have pulled a one, so what you have left with is 80. So 80 minus 35 is as good as 85 minus 40, which is 45. Understood? I'm just pulling a one to make this because 22 minus 78 to ho nahi sakta. So basically you are pulling a one, jo normally karte ho in subtraction. So you pull a one. So 122 minus 78, which is again as good as 124 minus 80, 22 added. Which is 44, and as you pulled a one, upper mein 80 bacha hua hai. So 80 minus 35, tumhe to karna bhi nahi hai, in fact, ye cheez. But anyhow, just saying. Achha, now coming to that, I'll take two examples. I'll take that 91 square wala example and ek 73 square tha. So I'll take these two examples. Dekho, steps are exactly same. ठीक है, दो अलग-अलग process याद रखने का जरूरत नहीं है. एक ही प्रोसेस याद रखो उससे मतलब कोई भी टाइप का स्क्वायर हो जाएगा. इनफैक्ट थ्री डिजिट का स्क्वायर भी हो जाएगा इससे. थोड़ा सा कैलकुलेशन होता है. आई विल कम टू दैट. व्हिच वन? 5329. 73 स्क्वायर इज 5329. दैट इज करेक्ट. या दैट इज करेक्ट. देखो 91 स्क्वायर अगर देखोगे फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस प्रोसेस नीड्स टू अप्लाई आई मीन यू नीड टू अप्लाई डेविएशन फ्रॉम अ मल्टीपल ऑफ 50. So all you have to understand is which is the closer multiple of 50. So if you are dealing with two digit numbers only, 50 or 100 are the two multiples of 50 that can be close, right? 50 or 100 ka average kya hai? 75. So 75 se agar ek number bada hai, then you take a deviation from 100. And agar 75 se chota hai, then you take a deviation from 50. That's it. So 91 ke case mein, we'll take a deviation from 100. And 73 ke case mein, we'll take a deviation from 50. Okay. Now, if you check the first one, 91 ka deviation from 100 kitna hai? What is the deviation of 91 from 100? Deviation matlab difference basically. That's what I'm... 9, but the sign is very important, Shantan. So 91 is less than 100 or more than 100? So basically, yeah, so that would be minus 9. Okay, so the deviation is minus 9. So keep a mental note of it or write it down, whatever. Initially, you should write it down, but you should always force yourself to do this thing mentally. Otherwise, koi fayda nahi hai. Again, 73 ke case mein, deviation hum log kahan se dekhenge? 50 se. What is the deviation? Plus or minus, Ikshita? Yeah, that is correct. Plus 23, right? Okay, so the first step in both the cases, what you do is the number ke saath just add the deviation. Add it matlab with the sign, of course. So in this case, kya hoga? 91 minus 9, which is 82. And in this case, it would be 73 plus 23, which is 96. Theek hai? This is the first step. Second step, what you do is to this, whatever you got as the result of the first one, you multiply the 50 wala multiple, jahan se deviation dekha tha. In this case, humne kahan se dekha tha? 100 se. To 100 se multiply karna to easy hai. 82, 100 khatam. 50 se multiply karna bhi easy hai. I already discussed this. 96 ko half kar lo. Kitna hua? 48 aur piche 2 zero. So 96 ka half is 48 and then you just apply 2 zeros behind because 50 matlab kya hai? 100 by 2, right? Same thing. Jaise 5 multiply kar raha tha, 10 by 2. Theek hai? Second step. Third step, this is where that 24 square wala thing comes in. the last step is you need to add the deviation square. So in this case, it's a deviation ka square kitna hai? 81. So you simply add it. You get 8281. In this case, however, it's 23. 23 ka square agar yaad nahi hai, to koi fayda nahi hoga. So that is what I'm saying. You have to remember up to 24 square. The reason being, देखो अगर हम लोग deviation देख रहे हैं from 100 और 50, 150 का average 75 होता है ना, तो maximum deviation कितना हो सकता है? 25 तक हो सकता है. अब 5 से ending का square का एक special process है, most of you might know that. तो उसके लिए मैंने जान ही रहा हूँ, इसलिए मैं बोल रहा हूँ 24 square तक याद रखना बहुत important है. ठीक है, clear हुआ? Any step needs clarity here? लास्ट स्टेप इज सिंपली एडिंग द डेविएशन स्क्वायर. अजय जैसे 91 के केस में डेविएशन कितना था? अजय 91 के केस में डेविएशन कितना था? डेविएशन फ्रॉम 100 जो पहले रिकॉर्ड करके रखा था, -9 ना, तो इसका स्क्वायर क्या है? 81, you simply add 81 to this 8200. So 8200 plus 81, iske saath add kar raha hu, kuch nahi. In this case, jaise 23 tha, 23 square. Acha 8200 kaise aaya? Acha fir se main sare step repeat kar raha hu. The first step, what you do is number, jo bhi number hai 91, uske saath deviation adjust karo. To 91 minus 9, kitna hua? 82. सेकेंड स्टेप, जहां से डेविएशन देखा था उसको मल्टीप्लाई करो. तो इन दिस केस यू हैव टेकन द डेविएशन फ्रॉम 100, सो यू सिंपली मल्टीप्लाई 100. तो 82 इनटू 100 कितना हुआ? 8200. दैट इज द सेकेंड स्टेप. थर्ड स्टेप, जो भी डेविएशन था नंबर का उसका स्क्वायर को ऐड कर दो. सो यू हैड अ डेविएशन ऑफ -9, सो यू जस्ट ऐड द स्क्वायर ऑफ इट. सो 81, तो 8200 प्लस 81, सो यू गेट 8281. ठीक है, क्लियर? इस केस में भी 73 के केस, 73 का डेविएशन फ्रॉम 50 इन दिस केस, बिकॉज 50 इज क्लोजर, इज +23. तो नंबर के साथ डेविएशन ऐड करो. 73 प्लस 23 कितना हुआ? 96. इन दिस केस वी टुक अ डेविएशन फ्रॉम 50, राइट? तो व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज 96 इनटू 50. नाउ एज आई सेड, हाफ दिस, डबल दिस. इसका हाफ 48, इसका डबल 100, तो मतलब 4800. So what you get is 4800, and finally deviation square. 23 was the deviation. Uska square kitna hua? 529. So you simply add that. 5329. Hopefully clear now. Great. Okay. Now, trust me on this. I mean, you can actually apply this to any sort of number. I mean, even if you have something like, let's say, 123. So, isko kaise karenge batao? 123 square karna hai mujhe. So, what would be the first step? First step ka answer do mujhe bas. First step ka answer do. Not 100 plus 23, number plus 23. The number is 123. Uske saath 23 add karna hai. To kitna hua? Padafat. 123 plus 23 kya? So that is the first step, right? Second step ka answer kya hoga? Deviation kahan se dekha? Usko multiply karna hai. Haan, to multiply kiya to kya hua? Last mein do zero. 150 माइनस 23 क्यों करेगा भाई? ऐसे ही तो 100 से ही तो नजदीक है. 150 करेगा तो बीच में वो 150 भी तो मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा, वो भी तो टफ है. और ऊपर से डिविएशन भी 27 है, ज्यादा दूर भी है, उतना मेहनत क्यों करेगा? तो 123 प्लस 23 इज 146, देन यू मल्टीप्लाई 100 बिकॉज 100 से डिविएशन देखा तो 146, फैंटास्टिक, करेक्ट, दैट इज करेक्ट. एंड फाइनली 23 स्क्वायर कितना हुआ? 529, सो सिंपली ऐड दिस 15129. क्लियर? इवन पता है रोहन, अगर मेरे को 127 स्क्वायर भी करना बोला ना, तब भी मैं 100 से देखूंगा, बिकॉज आई नो एक छोटा सा चीज है रोहन, 150 मल्टीप्लाई करना कुछ भी हो थोड़ा सा ज्यादा मेहनत है कंपेयर टू 100 मल्टीप्लाई करना, है कि नहीं? तो 127 अगर मैं 100 से ही देखता हूं तो मुझे 27 स्क्वायर लास्ट में ऐड करना है ना. ये मैंने 24 स्क्वायर तक याद करने क्यों बोला था, उसको याद रखो, वो लास्ट स्टेप डेविएशन स्क्वायर ऐड करना है. तो इफ यू नो 27 स्क्वायर इज 729 तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं है ना. तो 127 प्लस 27 154, 00 729 एडेड, सो 16129.